Good morning, students. In my previous lecture, I explained you about the Prime Minister, his power and function, and the composition and organization of the Council of Ministers. Now, today, first let me explain you about the distinction between the Council of Ministers and the Cabinet Ministers. Okay. Now, the term ministry and the cabinet are often used as interchangeable terms. Actually, they are not prior to the 44th Amendment Act 1979. Not a word about the cabinet was mentioned in the Constitution. It spoke only of the Council of Ministers. The 44th Amendment Act, however, provides that the President shall not issue a proclamation of emergency. Okay. Now, the cabinet here means the council consisting of the Prime Minister and the other ministers of the cabinet rank. How we will distinguish between the council and the cabinet of ministers? Now, first, that is, the Council of Ministers consists of all categories of the ministers: cabinet ministers, ministers of the state, and the deputy ministers. The cabinet, on the other hand, is a small group consisting of some 25 senior ministers. They are called the cabinet ministers. All cabinet members are ministers, but all ministers are not the cabinet members. Okay. Now, next, it is the in the day-to-day working of the government, the Council of Ministers as a whole rarely meets. The cabinet, on the other hand, is a small cohesive groups of the senior ministers who meet as frequently as possible. They together determine the policy and program of the government. While cabinet ministers attend meeting of the cabinet in their own right, ministers of state can attend only if invited to attend some particular meetings. A deputy minister is a junior minister. No junior minister can attend cabinet meeting in place of his chief, except in very extraordinary situation. Okay. Now, next is the Constitution says that there shall be a Council of Ministers to aid and advise the President in the exercise of his function. In fact, the President is to act on the advice of the Cabinet in all matters. Since the Council of Ministers as a whole rarely meets, it is the Cabinet Ministers who are consulted by the Prime Minister for information and advice which he needs. Thus, Cabinet is an inner body within the Council of Ministers. It acts in the name of Council of Ministers and exercises all powers on its behalf. Now, in your book, there's a one table is there where this distinguishes is mentioned there in 4 points. You just learn that 4 points. Okay. Now, next, let me explain you about the ministerial responsibility. Ministerial responsibility is the essential feature of the parliamentary form of the government. As in Britain, so in India also, the principle of the ministerial responsibility has two dimensions. One is collective responsibility and the another is the individual responsibility. Now, first let me explain you about the collective responsibility. Under Article 75(3) of the Constitution, the Council of Ministers shall be collectively responsible to the House of the People. That is what the term ministerial responsibility actually means. The ministers are responsible to the Lok Sabha, not as the individuals alone, but collectively also. Members of the cabinet swim and sink together. When a decision has been taken by the cabinet, every minister has to stand by it without hesitation. The essence of collective responsibility is that a measure accepted by the cabinet is regarded as the joint responsibility of everyone. Whether or not he was present at the meeting which reached the conclusion or whether he opposed it when discussed. A no confidence motion express want of the confidence in the government. It is generally moved by leader of the opposition. On conclusion of the debate, the speaker puts the motion to vote. If the motion is passed, the ministry has to resign. Now, let me explain you about the individual responsibility. Now, though the ministers are collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha, they shall be individually responsible to the head of the state. The ministers hold office during the pleasure of the president. It implies that the ministers shall be liable to be dismissed by the president for their undesirable activities. However, in these matters, the president acts on the advice of the prime minister. Usually, because of something that the minister has done, the prime minister asks him to resign, which he readily does. Besides, every minister is obliged to answer questions pertaining to his department. Okay, so these are the collective and the individual responsibility of the Council of Ministers, headed by the Cabinet Ministers, Council of Ministers, all are collectively and individually responsible to each other. Okay, now next let me explain you about the matters by the parliamentary and sous ministers' responsibility and all that. These all I have explained. So up to this is there in your chapter. Now one more point is there. Let me explain you. I don't know whether it is there in your syllabus or not. But let me explain you matters by which parliament ensures ministerial responsibility, control of the parliament over the executive, either the Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers is responsible to the Lok Sabha. There are several matters by which parliament ensures ministerial responsibility. Now these are to put to ministers questions which should be properly answered. No minister can afford to take a question lightly, because sometimes even a simple enquiry may lead to an unexpected volume of criticism. The questions give MPs and through them the general public some measures of control over the executive. Now next is the moving an adjournment motion for discussing an important matter that should have urgent consideration. Next, moving cut motions when the financial matters are under consideration. Next, moving censor motion against an individual minister or a group of ministers for their failures. And in last, moving a no confidence motion. Such a motion is moved by a member of leader or leader of the opposition. If the motion is carried, it implies loss of confidence and the government has to resign. Okay, so up to this it is there in this chapter. Now you read this chapter, listen my lecture carefully, and whatever the exercise work is there, you do it in your copy. Thank you. God bless you all.